Good morning, students. Welcome to PNMRC e-learning classes. Today we are going to start part 4 of chapter number 9, Reproduction in Animals. Students, today we are going to start our video with the topic Sexual Reproduction in Animals. Sexual reproduction is the most common method of reproduction in animals. In sexual reproduction in animals, there are two parents, a male and a female. The two parents have sex organs which produce sex cells or gametes. The male parent has sex organ called testes which produce male sex cells or male gametes called sperms. The female parent has female sex organs called ovaries, which produce female sex cells or female gametes called eggs or ova. The whole process of sexual reproduction in animals involves the formation of sperms and eggs, joining together of sperm and egg to form a fertilized egg called zygote. The growth and development of zygote to form a baby animal. The sexual reproduction in animals takes place in the following steps. First is, the male parent produces male gametes called sperms. The female parent produces female gametes called eggs or ova. The sperm enters into the egg. The nucleus of sperm fuses with the nucleus of egg cell to form a new cell called zygote. The zygote is a fertilized egg. The zygote divides repeatedly to form a hollow ball of hundreds of cells, which is called embryo. Embryo grows and becomes a fetus. Fetus means in which all the main body features of the baby animal have formed. Fetus grows and develops to form a new baby animal. Now, students, we will discuss sexual reproduction in humans. In human beings, there are special reproductive organs to make sperms and eggs. To bring together sperms and eggs for fertilization and make a zygote, and for the growth and development of a zygote into a baby. We will first describe the reproductive system of human male, that is man, and human female, that is woman, and then discuss how reproduction takes place in human beings. Students, first we will discuss about the male reproductive system. The human male reproductive system consists of the following organs, that are testes, scrotal sacs, epididymis, sperm ducts, seminal vesicles and penis. The human male reproductive system is shown in the figure in our next slide. Since the human male is called man, so we can also say that it is the reproductive system of man. Testes are the oval shaped organs which lie outside the abdominal cavity of a man. A man has two testes. Testes are the real reproductive organs in man. The male sex cells or male gametes called sperms are made in testes. Thus, testes make male gametes called sperms. Millions of sperms are produced in the testes. The testes are enclosed in two small bags of skin called scrotal sacs. The testes work more efficiently at a temperature slightly below the body temperature. So, they are held outside the body in a
scrotal sacs.
The sperms formed in testes come out and go into a coiled tube called epididymis that you can see in the picture. The sperms get stored temporarily in epididymis. From epididymis, the sperms are carried by a long tube called sperm duct into organs called seminal vesicle. Students, for that you have to see the picture. The sperms get stored in seminal vesicles. The seminal vesicles join to another tube called urethra coming from the bladder that you can see in the picture. Urethra carries the sperms into the organ called penis, which opens outside the body. These sperms are carried in liquid called semen. The penis is an organ for introducing sperms into the woman. The penis passes the sperms from the man's body to the woman's body for the purpose of reproduction. The male reproductive system is designed to manufacture sperms and to deliver them to the place where one of them will be able to fuse with an egg cell, that is female gamete, and bring about fertilization. Students, please note down that you all have to draw male and female reproductive system in your notebook. Now we will study the female reproductive system. The human female reproductive system consists of the following organs, and they are ovaries, oviducts, uterus and vagina. The human female reproductive system is shown in our next slide. Since the human female is called woman, so we can also say that it is the reproductive system of woman. Ovaries are the oval shaped organs which are inside the abdominal cavity of a woman. A woman has two ovaries. Ovaries are the real reproductive organ in a woman. The female sex cells or female gametes called eggs or ova are made in the ovaries. Thus ovaries make the female gametes called egg or ova. Students, this is the diagram of the female reproductive system in humans. This diagram you have to draw in your notebook. In this system, fallopian tube is there, uterus is there, ovary, cervix and vagina is shown. So, you have to draw this diagram in your notebook. So, we will continue with the female reproductive system. Just above the ovaries are the tubes called oviducts. The oviducts are also directly connected to ovaries but have funnel shaped opening which almost covers the ovaries. The egg or ovum released by an ovary goes into the oviduct through its funnel shaped opening. In human beings, one mature egg is released into oviduct every month by one of the ovaries. The release of an egg or ovum from the ovary is called ovulation. The fertilization of egg by a sperm takes place in the oviduct. The two oviducts connect to a bag-like organ called uterus or womb. At their other end, the growth and development of a fertilized egg or zygote into a baby takes place in the uterus or womb. Thus, uterus is the part where development of the baby takes place. The uterus is connected through a narrow opening called cervix to other tube called vagina, which opens to the outside of the body. Vagina receives the penis for putting sperms into the woman's body. So students, that's all for today's video. We will meet again with the remaining topic of this chapter in our next videos. Up till then, thank you and goodbye.